The keyword tracker is the tool that basically help you to track your positions of your product on Amazon. It's pretty much awesome tool. You can export products here, but at the same time, once you register for Sellerise, we automatically help you to track main keywords for your Amazon listings. I'm not sure if you know, but Amazon has a specific tools inside Amazon to see what exactly your product is indexed for and what is the main relevancy for your product. That's why we know exactly what you indexed for. We take these keywords, we put them inside your, this is demo account, so it's like, it's demo keywords, they're not real. But overall, you're gonna see the keywords, and from the moment you register for Sellerise, we start to track these keywords for you. It's gonna show like on what page it stays, positions, search rank, your trend, so much other information. It's also gonna track your pages and other stuff related to the keywords.
Like Amazon's choice, right? Stuff like that.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, exactly. Everything, you can see the trends here. Pretty much everything you need to track, as you can see, like Amazon choice pages, only one. But this is the demo account. This is not the real numbers. But we just put them here to make sure you understand how the system will look like for you. Keyword processor is also another tool that will help you to separate keywords from, let's say, duplicates, or you want to have a single keywords. I'm going to add here an additional tutorial because this will require us to do like more practical demo of like adding keywords and separating them, as you're going to see, like you can separate them by space, comma. You can also do additional, like you see, remove duplicates, single keywords, common words. There's some tools already similar to this. I just added here to make sure, like you, let's say you download the list and you want to remove all your competitor brand names. It also going to help you to do this. Or you want to remove numbers, and maybe like remove an async. So it helps you to process all this data. Or maybe you want to remove specific phrases. As I showed to you before, you can upload here entire list of your reviews and remove some words of Amazon or wherever you will need to do. Okay. Let's move to another two additional tools. It's called Keyword Hunter and Reranker. It's one of the most powerful tools, I would say, on the market for the keyword research. Let's go to, let's say, Keyword Hunter. The Keyword Hunter is help you to collect and do product research for entire category. Let's say we're going to take bicycle seat right now. Let me just click search. What does this Keyword Hunter do? A lot of tools, when you do keyword research, they're going to give you 5,000, 10,000 keywords. And a lot of these keywords, they doesn't make sense. And in majority of the time, when I see Amazon sellers, they actually don't understand like what type of keyword should I take first to rank. Do they just give you like three, four, five keywords that they think the most relevant one? And sometimes they cannot even explain, like they only look at the search volume, which inside Sellerise, we ignore this number because search volume, it's amount of searches that customer perform, but usually it doesn't equal to the amount of purchases he actually do. Inside Sellerise, we only count and we focus on actual sales per keyword on Amazon, which helps us and also convert. I'm going to give you like right now a few metrics that we focus on when we're trying to analyze the niche. So for example, in the bicycle seat, there's only 120 keywords that actually make in sales. Every other keyword that is available or maybe is going to be given by other tools, just don't waste money, you know, like it's gonna just create a problem for you when you're trying to rank your product. So this, if you're gonna rank for 120 keywords, that's exactly what will be required for you to be on the top of Amazon. So now you can see like there's 52 products that competing with you, and also the average market availability is 56%. I'm gonna explain to you later what does it mean market availability, which is also important number when you analyze your niche. Right here, you can see the keyword performance. This keyword performance, it's per specific keyword, like a bicycle seat. So we can, if I'm gonna scroll this to the right, I can see exactly sales per these keywords, but this is them account, so that's the data from August.
Yeah.
So, but you can just have a sense of information. So look, this is amount of sales per day per the specific keyword, and that's exactly what Amazon expect you to have as sales. Let me repeat this. Sometimes people, they look at numbers and they try to give away 50 units per day for the specific keyword. But Amazon algorithm, Amazon kind of brain, you know, like is so smart nowadays. It's going to spot that you was trying to manipulate system. So you have to sell as much as they expect. So if the bicycle seat, Amazon expectations is only 12 sales per day on position number one, then you cannot exist at the beginning more than that. Because if you will try to do 25, they know it's abnormal and they're going to penalize you for this and you're going to lose your ranking. Because the main idea is not only to rank to the top, it's to stay at the top. I hope you're following, you know, so.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah, and everybody following too. So that's very important. You also can download this data. If you download the report, if you can download this report, you'll be able to see this in an Excel file. So I make this more like a pretty visual part. Let me scroll just down here. You can see the semantic core. That's the list of keywords that is 120 keywords. In this list, you can see the metric that we use. It's called SearchRank, which is primarily more like a BSR on Amazon, like a bestseller rank. It's a position of the power of the keyword. It's not a search volume. So, and right here, you can see the sales. And this sales is only organic sales. It doesn't include PPC. So that's why when you're trying to rank organically, you want to make sure you meet these expectations by Amazon and you're going to rank. The next part is here. It's called conversion, which is very, very important as well. Because a lot of time you try to take the keyword, but conversion is low. When we're trying to rank the keywords, we try to take the keywords that has conversion 18% and higher. I like the conversion 20% and higher. Because look, if you're going to rank for the keyword that has a conversion of, let's say, 19%, if the conversion is high, you're going to stay at the top. If the conversion is so low, you can be kicked out from the top positions. You're going to lose the amount of money that you spend for the ranking campaign, which is very, very important. And a lot of time, if you will check, let's say there's a tool that is showing you like search volume per keywords, you're going to see a lot of time that search volume doesn't equal to sales, which is absolutely true. A lot of tools, they don't have a true search volume. They kind of estimate the search volume. This is the most important part. And even people, when they go to Product Opportunity Explorer inside Amazon, it shows you combined search volume per 3-5 keywords or some category keywords. It's also is not helping to estimate the power of the specific keyword and a ranking campaign when you're trying to actually dominate. And like, for example, like you see like a bike seat for women, comfortable 17%, almost 18. It's a good keyword. It has a 880 sales per month, which is nice. And also another metric that we have is called other sales. What other sell means? This is the sales from top three of Amazon. Let's say we're going down here. You see like some, and this sells, other sells, it sells outside of top three. So when we're trying to rank for the keywords, we want to make sure that keywords that are we're ranking for, the other sells also higher than 40%. Because if, let's say the other sells is only, you see like, for example, here, like conversion 29%. But other sales is only 8%. So if let's say we was running a ranking campaign and we couldn't get to the top three, then outside of top three, there's almost no sales. And we wouldn't be able to get this money kind of back from what we invested into the ranking campaign. But if let's say there's a 60% sales also stays outside of top three, then we would be able probably to get 49, 47%, you see. So we use a formula of two main metrics. Metric number one, it's conversion per keyword and also other sales. And that's how we prioritize what keywords we're going to use for title, for ranking campaigns. And that's, it's kind of, I would say like bird view, you know, like, so there's a way more analytics that we use when we're trying to rank the, do the ranking campaigns. So also the next tab we have, it's
Dima,
related.
What is the saturation there in semantic core? We had the other parameter saturation, or it's the second on the left.
So the saturation is a metric that we use as so let me explain it this way. When we build this keyword list, we're trying to combine you a list of keywords that been visible in other competitor products to make sure that keyword is valuable. So let's say if we're going to have here keyword Starbucks, they're probably not a Starbucks, Schwinn, you know, like, so Schwinn was only, the saturation is 10, which means 10 ASINs been using this keyword, but we know it's a brand name keyword. So probably we're going to skip this keyword, but overall the keyword is so powerful. The saturation is amount of ASINs that actually dominating in this niche, you know, like of the keyword.
That
So,
means it appeared in top of search dominated,
yeah.
You mean? Oh, okay.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Throughout 640 days, you see?
Yes.
So, yeah, it's been switched. Yeah. I don't use this metric saturation. We just have it because some people ask for it. But overall, maybe someone will find this helpful. So I would say this way, the higher the number, of this saturation, it means the more people been switching top positions for this keyword throughout 640 days. So people probably couldn't hold the hold the position or something, you know. So
I understand. Yeah.
Then we go to related products. That's all the products that kind of been used for combining this semantic core. So we was taking keywords from these guys, making sure they all crossed. But we also have another tool which is called Keyword Re-Ranker. The Keyword Re-Ranker is also showing you additional keywords that kind of been missed inside the semantic core. But usually it's keywords more specific to the niche. Let me give you an example. For example, you want to sell bicycle seat with LED light. So when you type here bicycle seat, we're going to try to find all the products that have been sold in a bicycle seat. And if bicycle seat with LED lights been sold only by one ASIN, this keyword is not going to be visible here. But you would be able to find this keyword by downloading data from these top guys. And I'm going to show you right now how to do it. And then once you combine this list, you will going to have the most comprehensive list of all the keywords that will help you to dominate in the bicycle seat niche.
So like the big keywords that got a lot of sales, and even the small keywords that got sales here and there,
you're still going to have them.
But they're not appearing in the other table in the semantic core.
Yeah.
We can still use them because they're still, they at some point have gotten sales, and maybe you, why not?
Yeah. If you are related, if let's say you have sell bicycle, if you sell bicycle seat without LED light,
doesn't
then you don't
sense.
Need this keyword because you're not relevant. And even if you're gonna try to rank for this keyword, even if the keyword it has sales, it doesn't make any sense for you because you're just gonna waste ranking budget. That's why the system is built at the filtration level, as you see. Like you have a semantic core, and then you have people like other ASINs who was doing the sales, you know. So yeah, you also can see there's some insights here. Competitor analysis, that's another tool that also powerful. Here we combine three top guys and take their analytics and also get the keywords from top three guys that been used and bring sales to them. As in semantic core, there's, you can see in related products how many people we took to analyze the data and combine the data to make sure we have all the most comprehensive semantic core. But in competitor analysis, we take only three top guys who've been on top three for the last 641 days, the main guys who get the most amount of sales. And then we can see the keywords that was bringing sales to them. You also can download this list and take the keywords from here. From my experience, when I try to download semantic core, and the moment I try to expand by downloading data from my competitors, sometimes I find maybe 5-6 more keywords, sometimes none, you know, to make sure I just my list is complete. So I would say semantic core is very, very complete list. But overall, we inside our SOPs for our team, we tell them always download the reports from top five guys, remove duplicates, and put the keywords that we're missing. If these ASINs are similar with the values what we're selling. So as I was mentioning, bicycle seat with LED light, I would find bicycle seats with LED lights, download their re-ranking report, which I'm going to show you in a minute, and then just take this list and combine it. So basically, you're going to download the report. It's going to look like an Excel file. And then let me just show you like keyword re-ranker, because basically we finished here. We'll go to keyword re-ranker. In keyword re-ranker, you can put any ASIN and just click search. Or if you're going to go, let's say, to keyword hunter, you go to keyword hunter, you go to related products. If you're going to click on any of these ASINs, it's going to take you to keyword re-ranker. And let me show you how it's going to look like. So let's say if you decide to go from here, you put the ASIN, you click search, and now it's going to show you a product with the name and photo. And then it's going to show the semantic core of this specific ASIN, which is, it used to be 300 keywords that used to bring sales to this ASIN. Now it's only 7 at the top. So he, generally speaking, lost 293 keywords, which is a lot, you know, like, so probably this product is not performing as good as it used to be. And yeah, so you can see exactly what keywords used to bring him in sales. You can see what keywords bring in sales right now. So you can see the list. Majority, you see it's keywords with the brand names. Mm-hmm. So probably the guy just lost organic position on majority of the keywords. Let me show you like active keywords. But also the good part here as well, it's to see when he lost this position, you know.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So, and it's important. If you lost this position just recently, I would try to rank this keyword first, because Amazon still feel you're relevant. The same way, if you're going to go and let's say put your competitor here, let's say if you're analyzing your product, if you see that you lost your position just recently, try to rank it back, because it's going to be the most easiest for you. And also you can see which keyword used to bring you how many sales. So mm-hmm. you can evaluate the power of the keywords and like what was the power of this keyword towards your product. But then if you're going to look at your competitor ASINs, look at what keywords they lost, let's say 3 months ago, 4 months ago, 6 months ago, probably did they miss this point. And then take this keyword and try to rank it yourself if you're relevant. As I said, like bicycle seat with LED light would be easier to rank if the guy lost this ranking, let's say 3 months ago. Mm. You got it? So, and also you can download this report right here. As I mentioned to you, I'm not going to go through like, because it's more like already like additional step.
Yeah.
It's just combining Excel spreadsheets. Or you can go on YouTube and look for my video, how practically I do the keyword research with the Keyword Hunter. And Renek, I give there's like way more information, because this videos usually goes for like a couple hours.
And we'll leave it in the description for people to watch, maybe up here in the card as well. And we'll do that, yeah. Deal, of course.
Yeah. No. Already I gave like a lot of information for you guys just to digest, you know,
nice.
Try to work with this. And then after you digest this information, just try to implement, okay?
There was also Dima in Keyword Hunter Titles Founder, something like this.
Let me show you. Like Title Founder is all like beta testing tool. Not my favorite, to be honest, you know, like, so usually I skip this as a video tutorial. But overall, this is how it works.
Yeah.
This is how it works, you know, like you can click on any keyword. Let's say if you like some keyword and let's say you click it. Oops, sorry. So it's going to be added to the Title Founder. And then you kind of just build a tool. You see, build the title based on the keywords here, because now you can see all the data about keywords from here. Quite like that, you know. So you can change it, you know, like you can just remove some keywords. It's going to show you the matches right here. It's going to be updated. So, and also at the end, it's going to show you the power. The power, it's combined power of all the keywords that you added. Kind of a build that you let's say if you're going to remove the seat and you're going to add seats, then you're going to see, okay, how it's going to look now. But what is my main problem with this? It's you can have a duplicates here. So I'm still working on making title founder or builder. We call this like a title.
So the idea is to build a title right here and then have all the best keywords. So the power is big and the title is readable and we have all the best keywords in the title. If we can do that, right?
Exactly. Yeah, that's the main idea too. So you're not working in Excel file, but you already have all the data here and you already can combine, you know.
Yeah.
So that's you also can see, let's say you can copy and paste here a title from your competitor and you can see combined power of your competitor title.
Mm-hmm.
So it's also going to help you because it has a lot of information together combined and analyzed for you at the same time.
Nice, man. Nice.